Happy February, babies.
What month comes next after January? February. February.
I've smashed 1 month of 2024 already. What? What? That's crazy. This video is one, a little check-in. I'm gonna do a book review of what I've read this month, checking with you and how I've got on in my goals. And if this is the little kick up the backside that you need to make sure that you are refocusing back on your goals, you haven't quit within 1 month, which is fine if you have, this week we'll realign and make sure everything's going well. So make sure you carry on watching. If you are new here, my name is Antonia. I make all different type of videos. Last one, she was quite fruity. Feel free to go and watch it if you love a cheeky little story time. But I do a lot of unboxings. If I go traveling, I'll take you there with me. So if you're interested in any of that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you are back from the video, hello, horn. Welcome back.
And I need you. And I miss you. And now I wonder.
2024 could have gone in any different type of way for you. It's only been 4 weeks in, so if it's being rubbish, it's fine. We close that month over, it's done. We don't need to even think about January anymore because now we are in February. We are in the month of love. We love to see that. For me, it's going to be a big month of self-love because that's what we love. This is a whole year about self-love and falling in love with ourselves. I achieved nearly every single one. The one I actually let myself down on was actually YouTube, weirdly enough. So I had a goal of working out at least once every single week, which I did every single Monday. It was only a YouTube video, a little dance routine, like 30 minutes, weren't anything crazy, but it was enough to move my body around at least once a week. So this month, we're upping that to twice a week. I said, slow steps, build it as a habit. Implementing it in slowly rather than trying to do 5 workouts a week is what's working for me. So if that is something that you're trying to work towards, break the goal down into smaller steps that are more achievable. My second goal was to make sure I walk Jessie every single day. So if you don't know, Jessie is my miniature dachshund, my little mini sausage dog. And I do walk her pretty much every day, but I'll let the weather sometimes control it, or like she goes to the toilet in the back garden, I'm like, oh, we'll leave her for tonight. No. In that snow, in that rain, we were out in a little walk every single night. So I'm so glad that we've done that. Other goal was to journal every single day. I did get the 5 minute journal. For me, it's been the best thing ever. I've journaled every single morning, every single night. Like, no doubt, it's sat next to my bed every single day. It's the first thing that I do as soon as I open my eyes. And honestly, it's just been so good to make me sit there and think of 3 things that I'm grateful for every single day. Just set your mood. And then at the end of the day, it allows you to reflect on that day. And you have to pick 3 good things that happens, which is amazing to finish your day on a positive outcome. No matter what kind of day that you had, you're always gonna have that positive outlook, going to sleep and having the best dreams ever. The other goal that I had, which is the one I didn't fully achieve, was to make sure I upload this every single week, at least once a week. I struggled to get that Wix video on. Just put off trying to edit for ages, and then I was going out quite a lot, so I just didn't really give myself that time, which was just really silly because I am really serious about YouTube and really want to put my effort into this. So that's something I'm making sure that I at least achieve this month. Don't get me wrong, technically I did upload every single week because I've done a couple of short videos, but I wanted like the obviously long videos to go on there, and I didn't achieve that, but it's fine. It's fine.
I'm fine.
Really?
Absolutely. I'm fine. Totally fine. I don't know why it's coming out all loud and squeaky, because really, I'm fine.
The other goal that I did was to read at least 1 book, and I actually ended up reading 2. This is all on my Kindle Paperwhite. If you haven't seen the video of me unboxing this, I will link that here. Please feel free to go and see it. I actually performed really well, that video, on the Kindle. Love it. I actually read the King of Wrath series, well, King of Sin, actually, the series is called. Let me not call it a wrong name. So good. I finished King of Wrath in 3 days. That was the first book of the series. I'm not gonna lie, for me, that was the best one. Like, Dante could do anything he wants to me for the rest of his life. Every day. It was very spicy. It was just, oh, I loved it. I loved the love story. I felt like I didn't, like, I kind of knew what was going to happen. Like, for each one, there's kind of a bit of, like, a drama involved in it, and I love that. Like, I love that it's not just a full romance. Like, that's obviously the main basis of it, but there's always like a little spar in the works. King of Prize was the second one in the series, so I finished that. Was the first book that I finished this year. It was good. I enjoyed the love story. I enjoyed the writing. Just wasn't the best. Like, it was really good. I just want more spice. Like, I enjoy the spice and I need it a bit more. King of Greed. That was really, really good. Loved the love story in that. Like, I think that was actually one of my favourite love stories. Again, I just wanted a bit more spice. Just give me a bit more spice. So I gave King of Wrath and King of Pride 5 stars, but I only gave King of Greed 4, which I actually think is a bit rude. I was actually saying the 5-star reads. Like, I really enjoyed them. I'm just thinking of a readability. Like, would I read them again? I'd probably read the King of Wrath again. Don't know whether I'd read the others. But again, that might just be me right now. I am currently already started my next series, which is Twisted Love. I'm on chapter 6 of that. So, really enjoying it so far. Again, all spicy books. We love a spicy book.
You naughty, naughty. You teasing me, you naughty, naughty.
Please let me know in the comments down below any book recommendations that you've got. I know I said this in the Kindle unboxing video, but if you're new here, let me know what you think. I love a bit of spice, but I like a bit of crime in it too. And that was the thing that I felt like was lacking a little bit with The King of Greed, was there was a little bit of like drama. I just could have done with a little bit more, that was all. So yeah, a little bit more spice, a little bit more drama. Like, just give it to me. Give me the crime. Give me the panic attacks. Like, I love to see it. I've done my skincare every single day and night too. Kind of get myself into a night and morning routine, and it's just been the best thing for me. The other big goal that I had this month was to lose 7 pounds, and I managed to actually lose 8 pounds. So absolutely made up with that. I've set myself the goal of losing just 4 pounds in February. I am 3.5 pounds away from my 2 stone awards, and that's like the main thing I really want to achieve. So as long as I achieve that in February, I'll be quite content. But yeah, that's kind of what I'm focusing on. I would like to set myself a bigger goal of like weight loss, but I just don't want to panic too much in case I don't get it and then I get really like self-sabotaging. So it's just a mental thing for me. Do the same for you. You don't have to be too harsh on the goals that you've got. Think of it from the bigger picture. Like, I'm looking at it as each month, if I just tackle a couple of pounds each month, by the end of the year, I'm going to be a lot less weighing than what I was at the start, which is the most important thing for me. To make sure you use this video as a prompt to go and write down whatever goals aligns with you. A couple of them might change, like a couple of things might work for you that you trialed in January and you might enjoy them. So you might want to do something else. You might want to up your goals, anything like that. The other thing I want to announce in this video is the giveaway winner. Now, I'm not going to lie, not a lot of people entered it. So the winner of the giveaway is...
Drum roll, please.
Sandra has won this. So I will send you a message and I will ask for your address and I will get that all sent over to you. So hopefully this will help you achieve all your goals in 2024. This video, that's pretty much it. In the next video, I'll be showing you how to make a vision board that works and make sure that, again, you just align with them goals. So that'll be our next video. So make sure that you subscribe if you'll be interested in seeing that. Really hope to see you in the next video. Thank you so much for joining me today. Nice little short and sweet one compared to the last one. Again, make sure you go and watch the Wix one. I will see you in the next video, my loves. But for now, bye bye.